Hello everyone, I'll be going over keyboard shortcuts for Musescore 4, so no matter if you're a beginner or intermediate, by the end you'll be making music a lot more efficiently. First thing is adding a note. All you guys know by now that you press N, you add a note, and if you want to add more, you do it like so. But I changed it to the letter E on my keyboard, so it's a lot easier for me to press it instead of going over to N. But you can change it to anything that you want, like some people put as F, I think. Next one is copying and pasting. You guys all know this. Press Control C, Control V to paste, and Control X, and Control V to cut. And it's really helpful if you're like, if you have something that's in the wrong position and you want to cut it. Control X, Control V. But let's say that this is too slow, and you want to make it into 16th notes or 8th notes. So what you do is Control X and then Control Shift Q. So that makes it into 8th notes. Control X, Control Shift Q. That makes it into 16th notes. I also like adding slurs on this. So if you want to add a slur, what you can do is you can select the first note, shift, select the end note, and that will select all the notes in the range, and then press S. That makes it a slur, but yeah, if you want to make it a staccato, you had to press Control S. And the cool thing is you can also select the last note of a different instrument, and it will select the box around it. And then if you press Control X, it inverts it. So if you want one, then you go there. But let's say you want the first note to be accented, you do Control V, and that adds an accent. And then let's go back to quarter notes. Now, if you want this to be repeated two times, then what you can do is select the range and then press R, and then it just repeat it. So instead of having to press Control C and then Control V, it's a lot easier if you just press R and that repeats it. If you want to change the duration of an individual note, you can press Q and V respectively. So you can do Q, it makes a half, Q, half again, W, makes a double, W makes a double again. You can also do this for half notes. So I have half notes as T on my keyboard, that's half and a half note. But you can also press Shift W and that also adds a half note. So for any note, you can add a Shift W and it adds a half note, or you can add the half note depending on what you are. But let's say you want to remove a half note, you can't do Control T, or if you can do T because it just makes two half notes, right? So what you had to do is you have to do Control Q and that removes a half note. So instead of slurring that, instead of pressing S, you can also press G and that adds a tie. So a little bit of melody here. Right, and then let's say you want to add slurs. So slur, 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 slur. And it's too slow, so we're going to shift, select, Control X, and then Control Shift Q. And then maybe you want this to be accented instead of staccato, so shift S, shift V. And then you want to repeat it, so shift, click, and then R, and then repeats it. But let's say you want this to be an octave higher. Instead of looking at this note, going to the next note, you can just press Control and up arrow, and then it just does that. So that's pretty useful. Next part is lyrics. So let's say you're writing in some kind of choral piece. You want to like slur everything, right? And then if you want to add a lyric, what you can do is Control L and add some notes. So goes underneath that. Now let's say you want to break some words. So if you want this to be two notes, and then what you could do is just press the minus key and then does that. Yeah, so that's all the keyboard shortcuts that are really useful to me and pretty much helping with the workflow. So I hope that helps.